Hello, hello, mic check. Hello, hello. Okay. Who is Robert Vadra? Take one. A fitness freak, a page three regular, a passionate biker. He's one of the most talked about sons-in-law in the political circle. And more often than not, Robert Vadra is a man embroiled in controversies. In an embarrassment for the grand old party, the Congress president's brother-in-law and businessman, Robert Vadra, along with former Haryana Chief Minister Bhupinder Singh Hooda, has been booked by Haryana police for alleged irregularities in land deals in Gurugram. A case has also been filed against the real estate giant DLF and property developer Omkareshwar Properties.
नॉलेज में तो हमारी में उसी टाइम से था हम तो ये इंतजार था कि ये मामला चल रहा है कहीं न कहीं इसकी कार्रवाई हो रही है ढींगड़ा आयोग का भी ये था कि उन्होंने भी इनको दोषी ठहरा दिया है हम सुनते थे लेकिन हमारे पास कोई इस तरह की कोई प्रॉपर जानकारी उस टाइम नहीं थी जब हमें पता चला कि उस पर कोई स्टे हुआ है लेकिन वो दोषी ठहराया गया है तो अब हमने अपनी ये एप्लीकेशन मूव करनी उचित समझे कि अब हम अपने ये दरखास्त पुलिस स्टेशन में देंगे और इनके जो चेक बोगस चेक जो है जिनकी एंट्री ना कोई किसी खाते में लगा है ना कोई ट्रांजैक्शन हुई है इधर से उधर मगर ये इन सबूतों के आधार पे ही इनकी इनका मुकदमा दर्ज हो जाएगा मुझे किसी तरह का कोई डर नहीं है मैंने अपने सोच समझ के दिए फियर प्रूफ आदमी हूँ मुझे डर वर मेरे नज़दीक आता नहीं है
अकॉर्डिंग टू द FIR रॉबर्ट वाड्रास फर्म स्काईलाइट हॉस्पिटैलिटी प्राइवेट लिमिटेड वाज रजिस्टर्ड इन 2007 with a mere capital of 1 lakh rupees. In 2006, Omkareshwar Properties bought 3.5 acres of land in Gurugram for 18 crore rupees. In 2008, it purchased 3.5 acres of land in sector 83 for 7.5 crore rupees from Omkareshwar Properties. The 7.5 crore check given to the seller was never encashed. Soon after getting a license to develop a commercial colony in 2008, Skylight Hospitality sold off the land to DLF for 58 crore rupees, making a windfall profit. The charges against Robert Vadra in the case are of criminal conspiracy, fraud and forgery.
It is a case under registered under Prevention of Corruption Act. We are already giving the investigation to a guested officer, ACP Manesar, and he will carry out the investigation further.
While Vadra has accused Modi government of trying to divert people's attention from real issues, the BJP has pledged to let the law take its own course.
भ्रष्टाचार से लड़ाई तो हम पहले दिन से लड़ रहे हैं और इस नाते से जो जो चीजें हमारे पास मटेरियल जितने थे वो सारे केसेस जो है कोई सीबीआई में चल रहा है कोई सुप्रीम कोर्ट में चल रहा है कोई विजिलेंस में चल रहा है उनके सबके परिणाम उन एजेंसियों के माध्यम से आएंगे एक प्राइवेट व्यक्ति ने उस प्रकार का जो एक साहस करके ये FIR कराई है उस FIR को के माध्यम से जांच होगी और जांच में जो भी पाया जाएगा दोषी उसके खिलाफ कार्रवाई
दिस इज व्हाट आई एम सेइंग दिस ऑल पॉलिटिकल वेंडेटा दैट दे हैव द बिहाइंड द स्क्रीन दिस गवर्नमेंट हैज गॉट द This FIR registered by a private company. I have got full faith in the judiciary and this government has totally failed. Everybody understands. In 4 years, they couldn't find anything. So they are taking such steps. This is all political vengeance, political vendetta, political witch hunt, witch hunting they are doing, nothing else. Just to divert the attention of the people.
In May 2015, the BJP government in Haryana set up a one-man Justice S.N. Dhingra Commission of Inquiry to probe the grant of licenses for prime commercial properties in Gurugram, including those to Robert Vadra. The commission submitted its 182-page report to the Khattar government on August 31, 2016. It was the Justice Dhingra Commission that recommended action against former Haryana Chief Minister Hooda, officials of State Town and Planning, Revenue Department and Robert Vadra's company, stating that rules were set aside to benefit influential people. exposing the alleged nexus between politicians and bureaucrats. The report also hinted at possible criminal conspiracy between government officials, real estate companies and politicians.
My mandate was to inquire about irregularity in grant of lease. Agar irregularities nahi hoti to main sirf ek sentence ki report deta ki isme koi irregularity nahi. Meri report mein 182 page hain. तो बिना मिले 182 पेज लिखने के लिए मेरे पास कोई कारण नहीं था. यू सी आई हैव नेम्ड ईच एंड एवरी पर्सन हु इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल सर. वेदर प्राइवेट आर गवर्नमेंट एनी पर्सन हु वाज इन्वॉल्व इन द इररेगुलरिटीज हैज बीन मेंशन एंड द रूल हैज आल्सो बीन मेंशन.
The report outlined how farmers sold land to real estate developers at a very low rate, after which the Huda government changed land use pattern from agricultural to commercial. The change in land pattern meant farmers and the public exchequer suffered mammoth losses. However, Congress leveled allegations of impropriety and conflict of interest against Justice S. N. Dhingra, demanding dismissal of inquiry report submitted by him. In 2012, Arvind Kejriwal, then a part of India Against Corruption, leveled a series of charges against Robert Vadra.
अगर कोई सैकड़ों करोड़ रुपया किसी को दे रहा है तो इसमें क्या माना जाएगा? कॉमन सेंस किसी की क्या कहती है? किस लिए देगा? और जो ऐसा व्यक्ति है कि बड़ा असरदार, यानी जो यूपीए के चेयरपर्सन इंडियन नेशनल कांग्रेस के प्रेसिडेंट का दामाद है, तो पॉलिटिकली बहुत इन्फ्लुएंशियल है, तो अगर उसको कोई इतना बड़ा फायदा.
They alleged that Vadra's wealth grew from 50 crore rupees to 300 crore rupees within a span of 3 years.
FIR तो कम से कम आज रॉबर्ट वाड्रा के खिलाफ FIR तो तुरंत दर्ज की जाए. जो आदमी इस देश के अंदर 15,000 रुपए का बिजली का बिल नहीं देता एक मजदूर, उसके खिलाफ 24 घंटे में FIR कर देती है शीला दीक्षित. लेकिन अगर कोई आदमी 50 लाख से 300 करोड़ रुपए बना लेता है बिना किसी काम धंधे के, उसके खिलाफ FIR नहीं होती है.
Angry at India and Kejriwal for raking up his business dealings, Vadra posted on Facebook, "Mango people in a banana republic," a statement that created furor and forced him to shut down his Facebook account. In October 2012, IS officer Ashok Khemka cancelled the mutation of the Gurugram land for allegedly violating rules and regulations. 3 days after he ordered a probe into the land deals between Vadra and DLF, Khemka was transferred as the DG, Haryana Seed Development Corporation.
It's not appropriate for me to hazard a guess on why I am transferred. This question is best asked to the decision maker in the government who were responsible for transferring me prematurely. During the course of my duty, one particular transaction had come up and I tried to pass an order without fear and favor, as I would have done to any other citizen. And that's left for the people to judge whether that order is restores the glory of the government or indignifies it. That's best left for posterity to judge.
From being an ordinary man from Moradabad with a lackluster business to being Priyanka Gandhi's husband, a panache for racing cars and designer clothes, life so far has been nothing less than extraordinary for Robert Vadra. Robert was born to Rajendra and Maureen Vadra in 1969 at their Moradabad home. His father ran a brass and wood handicrafts business. Robert completed his schooling from the British school in Delhi and met Priyanka Gandhi when she was 13. Priyanka was a friend of Robert's sister, Michelle, who died in a road accident in 2001. Robert and Priyanka Gandhi's wedding in February 1997 at 10 Janpath was a private affair with very few friends and relatives in attendance. For quite some time, the low-key Vadra remained out of the public eye. This was the time when he ran Artex, a company that dealt in costume jewelry in bone, wood, plastic and black metal. The first controversy arose in 2002 when Robert Vadra issued a public notice in daily newspapers that he had nothing to do with his brother and father.
Way back in 2002, he issued a public notice disassociating himself from his family. And he said that his father and his brother are misusing his name and his relationship with Gandhis. And if you remember, his father has sued him for that notice. Later on, few years later, his father died in very suspicious circumstances. His brother died. Even his sister died in a road accident. So, but as of now, as we know, he's having very good relationship with his mother, and mother stays with him.
In the years that followed, Robert fine-tuned his appearance, wearing designer labels and sharp cuts. He was frequently spotted at clubs in Delhi. By 2007, Robert Vadra was a middle-of-the-road businessman with all the prospects of an exporter of brass who had not managed to export much, but had the contacts to grow at a pace that power can propel. He set up three companies with Mother Maureen as director, and then there was no looking back. Vadra scaled up and diversified his business, acquiring tracts of land in Haryana and Rajasthan. A 50% stake in a leading hotel in Delhi and attempting an entry into the business of charter aircraft. Robert lost his father when Rajendra Vadra was found dead in a Delhi hotel. Until about 2010, Vadra remained pretty much in the shadows.
In 2011, Robert Vadra made a quiet entry into the real estate business, including a partnership with Reality Behemoth DLF Limited. In 2012, Vadra struck gold through sale and purchase of land in the parched deserts of Bikaner, Rajasthan, you know, pocketing a cool 100 crore rupees in the process.
Vadra went on a land buying spree through six of his companies. Messrs. Skylight Hospitality Private Limited, Blue Breeze Trading Private Limited, Skylight Reality Private Limited, Real Earth Estates Private Limited, North India IT Park Private Limited, and Lambodar Art Enterprises Private Limited.
In Rajasthan's Bikaner district, his company have bought land along with few other companies which were meant for compensation for the farmers whose land have been taken for setting up a firing range, and he bought that land at a very throwaway price. So that was the case. Haryana government has scrapped that mutation. Now the CBI is probing that case. That's the status of that case.
In 2012, before the Uttar Pradesh elections, Robert Vadra set the cat among pigeons, voicing his political ambition for the first time.
I've been here for many years. I see the people, I see the love and affection that I get here. It really makes me feel fantastic, special, if you may. But the way I look at it, things are that, I mean, if it wasn't for this family, then why politics? I'm a businessman, I'm involved in my business. But everything that I do, I put my heart and soul into. So I would come here, and if I were to partake in politics, It would only be if I could make a difference for the people and if I could dedicate my time and effort completely here. I'm not here for a post. I would be here to make a change.
Priyanka Gandhi rushed to do damage control, blaming the media for asking wrongly worded questions.
When this land scam, Vadra's land scam came into public domain, the first reaction of the Congress party was that he's a private citizen, we have nothing to do with him. But within few days, they came out in public with the full might and defended him. And in last parliamentary election, if you remember, Modi used it and he said that Damadji. And till date, the Congress BJP is utilizing it. And he, in fact, is a weak link for the Congress party on the issue of corruption.
Time and again, Vadra has provided the BJP with enough fodder to attack the Congress with.
ऐसा कोई नौजवान है क्या कि जिसके जेब में 1 लाख रुपया हो और 3 साल में 300 करोड़ हो जाए? है भाई, ऐसा कोई जादूगर है? देखिए, मां बेटी की सरकार का जादू देखिए।
मेरे पति के बारे में बहुत बातें कही जाती हैं, मुझे दुख होता है।
रोज कुछ न कुछ ये लोग बहाना बनाते हैं, गलत इल्जाम लगाते हैं। अगर कुछ ऐसी बात है तो बिना भेदभाव जांच करो। दूध का दूध, पानी का पानी, सबके सामने आएगा।
The Gandhi son-in-law has been photographed playing golf or riding a bicycle or posing with his superbike. But the most common photo opportunity catches him looking fit and strong as he walks along beside his wife. His connect to the Gandhi name and prestige. And it is the connect to the Gandhi name that Congress opponents latch on to when they target Vadra.
This area is a brotherly love affair. And this Bharatiya Janata Party is jhoot.
Once again, it is election season. And Bhupinder Singh Hooda, the former Chief Minister of Haryana, is also attracting the crowds back to his rallies. So politically, it is a doubly opportune moment for Hooda and Vadra being booked by the Haryana police.
For watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.